Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Nutter Butter Peanut Butter Truffles. And the name Nutter Butter comes from the kind of cookie that I'm using. I have done Oreo truffles before and they've been very popular. So I thought you would like something done in a similar fashion with some different flavors. And this is just a natural because it's a sandwich cookie called Nutter Butter. And you may use a different cookie if you like that's peanut butter flavored, or you could use something like ginger snaps or other things that you might like. Now this container is 1 pound. And you can see how many cookies it has. I'm just going to make half my recipe, so that means I will just use half the cookies. I will write up the recipe as if it's the whole recipe because I think it's a great recipe for you to make for a party. And you want to have plenty when you have a party. And you can just set them around in different places. But if you have only half a recipe, it probably wouldn't work that well. But for demonstration purposes, and so that Rick and I won't have too many sweets sitting around tempting us, I'm just going to use one column of the Nutter Butter cookies. And they are sandwich cookies, and they have this peanut butter spread inside, which you notice, and it will get blended up. So put that into a food processor and put the lid on. So I'm just going to pulse here and we'll see what happens with the cookies. I think that looks good. I'm going to take a look inside. Yeah, that's great. Now I'm going to put some cream cheese in. What I have here is half an 8 ounce bar of Neufchatel cheese. So you may use either one. Neufchatel is a little lower in fat generally than the cream cheese. I have cut the bar in half and then I have made it into portions and I've softened it. So that helps it to get incorporated. And here we pulse again. We want this to come together in such a way that we can form balls of it. And I think it's there. So I'm going to take some of my dough here. Call it dough now that it is formed like this, although it's already been baked and processed. What I want to do is make a 1 inch ball. So I generally just do this by hand. And you have something about like that. Doesn't have to be exactly 1 inch, but try to make them pretty even as you continue, and then place it in a pan or just something that is convenient with wax paper. And just keep doing that until you get all of your dough used up. Here I have my peanut butter truffles made, and you can see that I got 16 that are about 1 inch in diameter. And that means if you did the full recipe, which is double everything that I used here, you would get about 32. So just depending on what you need, you can increase the recipe or you can do what I've done and just do a half. These are going to a refrigerator and we're going to let them chill thoroughly, then they will get coated. Our peanut butter truffles have been chilling for quite some time, so I'm sure they're ready to coat. So I'm going to make the coating. The coating is going to be a candy coating that is vanilla flavored, and this is what it looks like. I've already used part of this package, so I only have part of it left. But what I will need is 12 ounces, and that's what I have here. And I'm going to melt this. This is easy to melt because it's meant for melting and coating things. So I'm just going to put it into a bowl here, and I'm going to cover that with some plastic wrap, and then take it to the microwave. I used 2.5 minutes at low power to get this to be nice and workable. And all you need to do is just pick up one of the chilled peanut butter balls and you can just put it in there and manipulate it with a couple of spoons. If you want to use a toothpick, that's fine. There are different ways of doing this. And just have something waiting, which in my case is going to be the same pan they came from. I've finished dipping all of these in the candy coating, and you can see what they look like. I had this much left, so if I had been a little more neat with them and trying to save this, I probably could have done a whole batch instead of just the half batch that I made. I'm going to make a little chocolate drizzle to go over the coating that we put on our peanut butter truffles. So what I have in here in this bowl is probably a half cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips. I really don't need this much because I'm just doing a little drizzle, but I was emptying out the ends of two bags. That's the only reason for saying that I've got a half cup in there. So I'm going to put plastic wrap over that. Here's my melted chocolate, and it took just 2 minutes on 50% power is what I used. And it's nice and melted, good for our purposes. So what I want to do is to put it into a sandwich bag. And this is just a Ziploc bag that is most easily filled if you put it over a cup or something like that and bring down the edges. And I'll use this large spoon to try to get some of this. We don't need a whole lot, but we want it down to the bottom. So bring it up and then close it. Pick one corner at the bottom, say this one, and make sure that it has the melted chocolate right to the corner. And take scissors and make a very small cut. Since this is going to be drizzled, we want a tiny drizzle over these. So I'll go to this one and show you what I'm going to do. Something like that. Here we have our chocolate drizzled Nutter Butter peanut butter truffles, and they're ready to put on a serving plate. You can see that they're set up. This is a little bit tacky still, but since I'm not going to stack these one on another, they're fine for sitting by each other. I just have to be careful not to touch the chocolate as I bring them out. I want to take a taste for you of my peanut butter truffles. I have some hot tea here. It's lemon tea. And I have a little dish that I'm going to put them on because they don't really deserve a big dish or a plate. So just take this one and the one right beside it. And this is really set up very well. This needs just a little bit longer. I had it in the refrigerator maybe 10 minutes. So this is what it looks like in the middle. It's really dramatic and I think very pretty. So I'm going to take a taste and see if it tastes as good as it looks. I'm getting a lot of that coating first. Now I'm to the point where it's just going to be the truffle. Oh, that tastes so good. I know I come across as a sweets person. I'm not really. I'm more of a meat and potatoes person. But sometimes when you taste something, it is just so good that you have to tell how good it is. And this really is one of those things. I think you'll love it.